Hey there guys, welcome back to the 5-9 channel. It's Gail right here. We're here with the new announcement of a Tapion and Minocia card coming to Dokkan. It's an LR, probably a legendary summon banner most likely. And with me we have Troco. Say hello.
How's it going?
And we are here to break down the unit kind of low-key just to see what his kit is, what our thoughts are. On your screens right now, we will be putting up the image of the card itself, as well as the SA animations and active skill. But before we get right into the kit and what his leader skill, super attack, passives are, Troco, what do you think about the Tapion and Minocia card we've gotten today?
I think it's pretty cool that it is an LR Tapion for a part 2 celebration type LR. I think that they didn't make him a 130% leader. I know we'll get into that more in detail, but I do like they went the LR Jiren approach with building the card to give some long-term relevance, because you know the 130 LRs, you don't really ever use them for the leader skill unless you have no other option. So they brought out an LR that wasn't really hyped, and they didn't make him, I guess, worse than he needed to be in terms of leader skill. And I mean hype level too, I mean people seem to be pretty happy it's a Tapion. I mean, he is that is a pretty popular movie. I mean, you have Dragon Fist, Goku, all that, so I am happy he's getting some more representation.
No, I 100% agree. His him being a swordsman, I mean, as a kid, I loved, like, swordsmen and stuff. And Tapion Minocia, or Tapion more specifically, was so cool back in the day. Movie 13 is definitely not my favorite by any means. I'd still maintain, I think, Fusion Reborn and the first Broly movie is higher. But Wrath of the Dragon is still high up because of Dragon Fist Goku, right? I will say as well, though, this has probably got to be... my hat's off to Dokkan. The SA animation and active skill, especially the OST with the ocarina, a thing of beauty, a thing of beauty, to be honest. But let's get right into the kit itself, and let's talk a bit about the leader skill first. Of course, we have a new category coming to the game called Timeless Legends. Now, this is a personal favorite of mine, I must admit. As much as I don't like them continuously doing new categories and not expanding on old categories that needed, like World Tournament and stuff, Timeless Legends just sounds cool, and I'm not gonna lie, I wanna see what's on the category. And he also leads Siblings Bond, key plus 2 HP, attack and defense 150. Now, let's talk about a bit about Timeless Legends. I'm really happy we're getting another Siblings Bond leader, considering the only other one is Gohan and Goten. Now we go on to a super attack. 12 key Brave Sword Attack causes colossal damage and lowers attack and defense, and 18 key Brave Heat Flash greatly raises attack for one turn and causes mega colossal damage and massively lowers defense. I actually prefer the 12 key more than the 18 key personally, because obviously lowers attack and defense, really useful for Super Battle Road, but the 18 key isn't that bad either. What do you think about the super attacks, Troco?
Yeah, I really wish the 18 key had lowering attack and defense, because massively lowering defense, it was really nothing. If it was massively lowering attack, oh my goodness, dude.
Oh, they would be actually built different. they would be the definition of being built different. Yeah, 100%.
Greatly raising attack, I mean, they're going to have good attack, because, I mean, just a quick look at their passive, you know, 130, 20, and 20, and then you give them another 50. Like, they're going to be hitting decently hard. I want to say Rainbow, they could probably be, what, in the ballpark of maybe 4.5 million?
Yeah, I think, well, one more thing to note, actually. Maybe. I don't know about their attack stat, but I do know their HP stat, I think, is the third highest of any LR.
Yeah, I don't know what their attack stat is.
I didn't check what their attack stat is, so somebody can obviously let us know in the comment section down below, or Troke, if you're going to look it up right now while we go on to the passives.
Yeah, because it was anywhere close
but,
to like
19 I know that. I definitely know that they are the third highest HP stat among the LRs, pretty sure. Now we move on to the passive, while Troco probably goes and sir hunts down for the attack stat. Legend of Planet Konatz.
What do SCR units get? 5,000 or 4,500?
I want to say 5,000. I'm not
exactly
sure. So
they'll be at just under 18,000.
Alright, that's a bit low, it feels like.
Yeah, it's not the highest. It's only not the highest.
It's definitely not the highest, but yeah, it's going to be very interesting to see what they do.
Mid-range, I want to think.
Yeah. Alright, so their passive is attack and defense 130. Timeless Legends category allies, key plus 2, attack and defense 20%. Siblings Bond category allies, key plus 2, and attack and defense 20%. Medium chance to perform an additional super attack when launching Ultra Super Attack. Minus 13% damage received for each super attack performed during the turn. So, I like it. I think they're great as a support unit. Obviously, they're going to be linking up with fellow Siblings Bond units and Timeless Legends category allies as well, which is great. I do like units that support as well, especially if their passive isn't anything that insane, or neither is their super attack or anything. So I'm cool with this. I think it's going to be good, especially for siblings bond. If you think about it, you know, we complain about Gohan, Goten not having any key links or, you know, struggling for key or any other siblings bond unit there may be. So them supporting the team would be great. In terms of their last part of the passive, it's good, but it's kind of like in LR SSB E Vegeta where it's only for that turn only. So you can only get up to a maximum of 39% provided you get both the passive additional as well as the hidden potential additional. What do you think about the passive, Choco?
I just took a look. Their defense, it's going to be like, what, 16k almost? Mm-hmm. It's 10,700 at base. At Rainbow, okay. That's gonna be like 15,000.
They're gonna tank then, especially yeah, if they get if you can get really if you can at least well. If you can at least get two additionals or and sorry one super attack and the additional at least one additional, that's gonna be really good.
Yeah, they have 170% defense from their passive and guaranteed minus 13% unless of course you're sealed, but that's whatever after super yeah. attacking. And if you lower their attack, like, You're taking nothing with this unit. They're a really, really good defensive unit. Offensively, you know, now seeing their attack set, I think they'll fall in the ballpark of 3-ish million. Because mm-hmm. they don't have a kind of lower attack set. Not anything crazy, but it's defensively.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very strong there, I think, defensively. I mean, most Tapion units, I feel, at this point are, like, just defensive. Well, I mean, Tech Tapion, not so much, but once he easy is maybe, who knows. But AGL Tapion is a perfect example of, like, being strong defensively, right? It's going to be very interesting. Now we move on to the active skill, however, and this is where things get really interesting, and I'm really appreciative of this, because I mentioned this in the PyCon breakdown video that we did a couple of weeks ago, where I said, you know, we need to get units that do more than just, you know, raise attack and defense, do this, and, you know, raise, like, attack for, like, 50% by 50% and key by 24. We need something unique, like a Ghost Usher mechanic or something, and this is what they are doing. So, their conditions, first and foremost, able to be used when four turns have elapsed from the start of battle, which is good, and there is another Timeless Categories and Siblings Bond Category ally on the team, so you need to have characters from both categories on the team. So I don't think they need to be the same unit with both categories. I hope not, because the only other units probably would be like AGL Tapion probably, and maybe one or two more. But you'll need to have one Siblings Bond and one Timeless Legends category unit. It'll depend on what the Timeless Legends category is. Honestly, I'm really looking forward to seeing what they have in that category. But the ability is removes all status ailments from all allies, and all allies key plus 2 and attack and defense 20% for 2 turns. Very similar to Bardock and Gine. And it's a Senzubin mechanic. So if you're stuck in IDBH or Battlefield or whatever it may be, where, you know, you're getting seal locked or you're getting rotation locked or something, you can just use Tapion's active skill and get free from it without having to use an item or anything. I really like this active skill. Like I said, we need more active skills that are unique, different from other units, and, you know, not just, you know, increase attack and defense consistently again and again and again. It's just, I really want more unique ones, like maybe like guard for the entire turn or for the next 2 turns or something like that. Choco, what do you think of the active skill?
I think it's fantastic. It's not going to be usable, or not in the first part, removing status ailments isn't going to be useful in many events, but when you can remove the ailments, it's going to be incredibly useful. What, I think God Event, a couple of them.
God Event as well, I forgot about the God Event. Yeah. Yes, you can.
So that's going to be super useful. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, you just have the 2 key and attack and defense 20% for 2 turns, which is also fantastic. That should work like the beat pan, I would imagine. So it's like, what, 28% instead? Something along those lines.
Yeah, it's very similar to Bardock and Gine, basically.
Fantastic. I just hope Timeless Legends category isn't restricted, and you don't require having both. Mm-hmm. But I don't imagine you wouldn't really run AGL Tapion, or at least Tech Tapion, alongside them. So it might not be too bad.
We'll have to wait and see. So their links are Hero, Experienced Fighters, Brainiacs, Cold Judgment, Solid Support, Fierce Battle, and Legendary Power. He shares 5 out of 7 links with, I think, the AGL one. I'm not too sure about the Tech one.
Does he have a single key link?
Solid Support's attack, I'm pretty sure.
Is Cold Judgment 1 key after the
attack? I think Cold Judgment's 1 key. I'm going to have to double check. But share some links with units like Tapion.
He gives himself 4 key in his passive.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to be fine for his own self, but his partner might have some trouble.
Well, as long as they're on his team, they're also going to be gaining 2 keys, so it's not that bad. Never mind.
I will say, he does share a couple of links with AGL PyCon as well, surprisingly, which I'm impressed by, to be honest. I think Experienced Fighters, Cold Judgment, Fierce Battle.
It's a shame they don't share a team, probably, where he'll support him. So.
Movie Heroes.
I mean, Tapion's passive.
True. Yeah, probably not. Probably
not. PyCon is somehow on Timeless Legends, which, who knows?
Yeah. No, Cold Judgment doesn't give key. Experienced Fighter doesn't give key, I'm pretty sure. Let me just jump into Tech Tapion and see if there is one there. If I can find Tech Tapion. There is no Tech Tapion here. Oh no, whatever.
While you're doing that, I'll cover the categories real quick. So
yeah, go over the categories.
We'll have to see how big that is. Movie Heroes is really good for his Tapion linking buddies. And then Siblings Bond and Joined Forces. Joined Forces is kind of a dead team. Unfortunately right now, but Siblings Bond might be better. I mean, it's definitely going to be better after this, but I'm starting to think, Siblings Bond units, what units would you really want to run on that team that you wouldn't run on Gohan and Goten team because they'd link better or support Gohan and Goten?
Yeah.
I mean, like, you have some of the Vegetas, you have some like Tarble.
Yeah, Vegeta's, Tarbles, you have 17, 18.
You have Whis and Beerus.
Whis and Varos, yeah. Beerus and Champa. But I mean, none of them will link. That's the problem. Well, again, that's kind of why I'm appreciative that they made him a support, because I think they realized that when they were making him that he won't be linking with anybody on his own teams apart from Tapions and stuff, right?
Like his own. So, yeah. Two of his categories are kind of dead. Timeless Heroes is probably where he's going to be fitting best.
Yeah. I think Timeless Legends and Siblings Bond is like his main leader skill. It's kind of like Videl, effectively, right? Where his own teams are going to be his shining points more so than anything else, I think. But I still like this character. I think they've done a fantastic job with him, considering all things said and done. It's just that, as I mentioned with Videl a couple of weeks back, it's just that he's only going to shine on his own teams. He's going to still do well in his other teams, but it's going to be very tricky fitting him in with everybody else, right? I'll still give it like a solid like 8 to 8.5. Like, I really like that he's doing a lot of things with the passive in terms of support. He's defensively strong. His active skill's really, really good. But yeah, what do you think, Troco? How would you rate him?
I think it's cool that we're getting more units that aren't just Saiyans. Because I'm sure Tape and Emotion can probably get, like, you know, maybe like 5 in the App Store, which, again, it's not top grossing, but that's still pretty good for any gacha in general. I'm not sure what their standards are they have, but in general, you know, still top 10 is pretty good. I imagine they'll get somewhere around there. It is nice to have another leader for Siblings Bond, even though I'm not sure how well they'll fit on the team. Yeah. And Timeless Legends is a promising category, and he is a support unit for the category, so...
I think it just comes down to how they build that category. Like I said, if it's the things we think it is going to be, then thumbs up. But otherwise, it's going to be very iffy. But yeah, let's wrap up there. Thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down below, what do you guys think of Tapion and Menosha? I personally believe they'll still do well. Like Choco said, it's easily, I think, top 10 worthy. I think especially the animations itself might carry him. Like I said, you know, Dokkan's come a long way, and especially because it's a collection game and more so like people are very interested in the animations and whatnot, I think people will be going in for that. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more Dokkan content on the 5-9 channel. Troco and I will see you guys next time. Peace out, everybody.